Risk Factors for Pediatric Delirium by Dr. Chani Traube.
With more and more delirium studies being completed, single institution, multi-institution, we are finding that the children at highest risk are the youngest children, the children under the age of 2. And this actually has great biological plausibility. This makes good sense. I like to think of age as a continuum. In the adult ICU population, the geriatric population are the patients at highest risk. I think similarly, at the extremes of age, the children under the age of 2 are at highest risk for developing delirium during the stress of critical illness. One can think of critical illness almost as a stress test that unmasks lack of physiologic reserve. So just like geriatric patients have less cognitive reserve, so do our children under 2. In addition to age, children who are most severely ill seem to be at the highest likelihood of developing delirium during their critical illness, which makes great sense. In addition, an independent risk factor for delirium, even after taking into account severity of illness, is positive pressure ventilation, need for invasive mechanical ventilation. We can't really do much about these risk factors. I can't control somebody's age or severity of illness. I'm certainly not going to withhold positive pressure ventilation from a patient who needs it. That's just identifying for your staff who's at highest risk for developing delirium. What's more interesting to me are the modifiable factors, the things that are actually amenable to our intervention. So happily, we've actually been able to identify some factors that are at least potentially modifiable. A really, really important one, and one that I've been focusing on a lot recently, are our sedation practices, specifically benzodiazepines. So in the longitudinal cohort study that I described earlier, ever being prescribed benzodiazepines, even just for a day or two early in the course, increased delirium risk more than 5-fold. This is after controlling for age, severity of illness, mechanical ventilation, and the other risk factors that are associated with delirium.